Is the Monport Reno 65 watt Pro the best value CO2 laser engraver? That's what we're going to find out in this video. This powerful CO2 laser engraver is great for engraving and or cutting many different materials, including wood, leather, acrylics, both clear and colored, stone, paper, glass, rubber, cork, and anodized aluminum. Just a quick note, CO2 lasers cannot be used for engraving or cutting bare metal. Metal engraving is typically done with fiber laser engravers. Hi, I'm Ken of Wrist Innovations, and I have organized the video into chapters listed in the description that will allow you to skip around the video depending on what is important to you. I would like to thank Monport for sending me the Reno 65 Watt Pro laser engraver for my evaluation. Okay, let's get started. First, let's cover the features. The Reno 65 Watt Pro is a 65 watt CO2 laser engraver using a 10,600 nanometer wavelength laser. It is a class 4 laser, which means you should always wear laser glasses or goggles to protect your eyes from the laser. The overall size of the Reno 65 is 1,000 millimeters wide by 690 millimeters deep by 285 millimeters high, or 39 inches wide by 27 inches deep by 11 inches high. And the unit weighs 40 kilograms, or about 88 pounds. So you'll want to get some help to move this thing around. The Reno 65W Pro has a 24 inch wide by 16 inch deep, or 600 millimeters by 400 millimeters work area, and it has a Z-axis height of 100 millimeters or 3.94 inches. It comes with a honeycomb bed as well as a set of rails that can be used for larger work pieces. The honeycomb bed is free floating, so in the near future, I will design and 3D print some locators to keep the honeycomb bed from moving around. Also, it has a pass-through slot in the front of the laser. However, you can't pass the workpiece through the back of the machine. The Reno 65W Pro has a maximum speed of 800 millimeters per second. The Reno 65W Pro can cut the following materials in one pass: 20 millimeters thick acrylic or 18 millimeters thick plywood. The Reno 65W Pro has a steel and aluminum frame with a tinted acrylic lid. There is an opening in the acrylic lid that acts as a handle, but this can potentially expose you to the laser, so you should always wear protective laser glasses or goggles. On the right side of the machine, it has the on-off switch, the emergency stop, and the connection for your computer. The back of the machine has the power cord attachment, the 4-inch diameter exhaust port, and the water inlet and outlet. The Reno 65W Pro includes a DSP controller with a 2.4-inch LCD display screen that allows you to move the laser head around. It has a frame function, and you can set your origin. You can also connect the laser to your Wi-Fi, and you can load files using the USB port. The Reno 65W Pro did not come with any instructions on how to operate the control panel. However, after I contacted their after-sales support group, they provided me an excellent digital manual for the control panel. If you need to make a part and you don't have the equipment, you can have your part made through the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. You can go to PCBWay's website, upload your file, and they can make it and ship it right to your door. PCBWay has a variety of services, including 3D printing, PCBs and PCB assemblies, CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding. I have personally used their services to 3D print a stainless steel insert for a high wear application. I have had a great experience working with their customer service and engineering teams, and they provided me with high quality parts in a short time frame. There is a link in the description below, and they will even provide you with a $5 welcome bonus. Thank you, PCBWay, for sponsoring today's video. Now, back to the show. Inside the machine, there are two sets of LEDs that light up the inside of the laser very well. The origin is in the right rear corner of the machine. There is an internal air pump that provides air assist during the running of the laser. Monport describes that the Reno 65W Pro as having a semi-automatic focus where you extend the plunger on the laser head and then you manually raise the bed of the laser using the supplied Allen wrench. As soon as the plunger retracts into the laser head, the workpiece is focused. Monport also provides a height gauge if you prefer to use that for focusing the laser head. The Reno 65W Pro is compatible with auto laser software, as well as the industry standard light burn software, and in fact, both are included with the laser. The Reno 65W Pro comes standard with an external submersible water pump that you would place in a bucket of distilled water. However, since the 65 watt laser generates a fair amount of heat, it tends to heat up the bucket of water pretty quickly. So, to extend the life of the laser, I recommend to purchase the optional 6-liter or 1.6-gallon capacity Monport CW-5200 industrial water chiller to maintain the water at an optimum temperature for the laser. I'll cover the cost of the water chiller in the cost section of this video. It has a crumb tray that slides out to allow you to remove any debris that is falling through the honeycomb bed. The Reno 65W Pro comes with an internal exhaust fan and a small length of 4-inch diameter flexible hose. However, the fan is not powerful enough for my installation because the laser is not close to a window. So I connected the hose to my large exhaust system that vents all fumes to the outside. I installed an AC Infinity 6-inch diameter inline exhaust fan that generates 400 cubic feet per minute airflow. So this thing can suck the paint off the wall. It has 10-speed settings and it's relatively quiet. A link is in the description below. I made a permanent installation through my wall, but you could also make a panel and install it in a window. Even though the Reno 65W Pro has a cover, there are some areas where the reflections of the laser could escape, especially by the open handle area, which means you can be exposed to the laser, which can damage your eyes. So it's critical that you wear laser-approved glasses or goggles. Monport includes a basic pair of laser glasses. However, they are not marked as certified. So I use this pair of laser glasses that fully protect my eyes. They are very comfortable and they are certified for this laser's 10,600 nanometer wavelength. A link is in the description below. The Reno 65W Pro also has an optional rotary accessory, which allows you to engrave cylindrical workpieces, such as tumblers, which I'll cover in a future video. Now, let's cover unboxing and setup. The Reno 65W Pro arrived in a wooden crate. Initially, I was a bit concerned because originally the lid was stapled shut, but when I received the shipment, the lid was only being held together with shrink wrapping, so I wasn't sure if someone had opened it during shipping. The good news is that once I unboxed it, everything turned out fine. As I mentioned earlier, the Reno 65W Pro is quite heavy at 88 pounds, so I asked a friend to help me get it onto my workbench. The accessory box includes a T-handle wrench, set of Allen wrenches, USB drive, user manual, power cord, USB computer cable, hose clamps, 4-inch diameter flexible hose, laser safety glasses, and a submersible water pump. I installed the honeycomb bed into the laser. Next, I connected the 4-inch diameter exhaust hose to the laser and to my main exhaust system. If you were going to use the supplied submersible water pump, then you would hook the hoses from the Reno 65W Pro to the pump and place the pump into a bucket of distilled water and plug the pump into an electrical outlet. Since I have the optional Monport 6-liter CW-5200 industrial water chiller, I hooked that up to the Reno 65W Pro. I connected the water inlet of the laser to the water outlet of the chiller and vice versa. Next, I filled up the chiller with 6 liters of distilled water. Also, Monport recommends that you add a few drops of Dawn dishwashing detergent and a few drops of an algae control chemical to the chiller to help with lubrication and reducing the possibility of algae growing in the water. I turned on the chiller first by holding the two buttons and turning on the power to the chiller. After a few seconds, the message RE will appear, followed by a temperature reading. This sets the chiller to an automatic mode. When you are turning on the laser for the first time, You should wait a few minutes for the chiller to fill up the laser tube with water before you turn on the laser. You can take the top cover off to see the laser to double check. Of course, make sure the laser is unplugged. Connect the USB cable from the laser to your computer and then turn on the laser. The laser will automatically home itself by traveling to the right rear of the machine. To focus the laser, use the T-handle wrench to lower the work table and extend the plunger on the laser head. Place your workpiece on the honeycomb bed and gradually raise the bed using the T-handle wrench. As soon as the plunger retracts back up to the laser head, the laser is focused. To connect the laser to my Lightburn software, I needed to download the driver. Once I did that, I was able to operate the Reno 65W using Lightburn, which is my preferred laser software. You can also manually move the laser head around using the keypad on the laser. Now, let's look at the impressive capabilities of the Reno 65W Pro by engraving and cutting some parts. The Reno 65W Pro excels in engraving and cutting a variety of materials. Let's look at 3mm thick plywood first. First, let's run an engraving test to find the best settings to engrave the plywood. In Lightburn, I chose Laser Tools, then Material Test. I picked a speed range of 300mm per second to 800mm per second in 6 increments and a power setting range of 10% to 30% in 5 increments. And I found the best engraving settings are 700mm per second at 15% power. For cutting the 3mm plywood, I set up another material test, but this time I picked a speed range of 10mm per second to 90mm per second in 9 increments and a power setting range of 30% to 90% in 7 increments. It looks like the best cutting settings are a speed of 30mm per second and a power of 60%. So, now let's cut some 10mm thick plywood. I set up another material test, but this time I picked a speed range of 2mm per second to 8mm per second in 4 increments and a power setting range of 70% to 100% in 4 increments. I zeroed in on an optimum speed setting of 4mm per second and a power of 90%. Now, for this thickness of plywood, there's a fair amount of charring on the edges when you try to cut this in one pass. But you could reduce some of that charring by cutting with lower power settings but multiple passes. One of the great capabilities of a CO2 laser is its ability to cut and engrave clear acrylic as well as colored acrylics. Other types of lasers, such as diode lasers and fiber lasers, can't cut clear acrylic. So I was excited to test out the Reno 65W Pro on acrylic. For my engraving material test, I picked a speed range of 100mm per second to 600mm per second in 6 increments and a power setting range of 10% to 30% in 5 increments. The best engraving settings are 400mm per second at 20% power. For cutting the 3mm clear acrylic, I set up another material test, but this time I picked a speed range of 5mm per second to 50mm per second in 10 increments and a power setting range of 55% to 100% in 10 increments. It looks like the best cutting settings are a speed of 20mm per second and a power of 70%. Now let's engrave some black anodized aluminum. I used Monport's recommended engraving settings of a speed of 500mm per second and 30% power at 0.08 increments to engrave my logo onto this business card size piece of black anodized aluminum. And it really turned out great. Next, I set up this engraving material test for this cork coaster. I picked a speed range of 200mm per second to 800mm per second in 7 increments and a power setting range of 5% to 30% in 6 increments. The best engraving settings are 800mm per second at 15% power, which is what I used to engrave my logo onto the cork coaster. Next, I set up an engraving material test for this slate coaster. I picked a speed range of 150mm per second to 750mm per second in 7 increments and a power setting range of 5% to 35% in 7 increments. The best engraving settings are 450mm at 25% power, which is what I used to engrave my logo onto the slate coaster. Now let's talk cost. At the making of this video, August 2025, the current pricing of the Reno 65W Pro is on sale at $1,999.99, normally $2,999.99. Also, during Monport's 5th anniversary sale, you can save an additional $200, so the final price will be $1,799.99. If you want to buy the optional 6-liter CW-5200 industrial water chiller, that is on sale for $469.99, normally $529.99. If you are interested in buying the Monport laser engraver, I have an affiliate link in the description below. Based on my research, I couldn't find a similar 65 watt CO2 laser engraver on the market for less than $2,000. I found an Omtech Polar Light 55 watt desktop CO2 laser engraver cutter at $1,999.99. However, the work area is only 12 inches by 20 inches and it has a maximum speed of 500 millimeters per second. So, it is a lower power laser and its work area is smaller and its speed is slower than the Reno 65 Watt Pro. The Polar Light does have an automatic focusing feature and a camera though. My final summary. In my opinion, the Monport Reno 65 Watt Pro CO2 laser engraver is an excellent value for the money. For less than $2,000, you can have a powerful 65 watt CO2 laser engraver cutter that can engrave and or cut a variety of materials, including wood, leather, acrylics, both clear and colored, stone, paper, glass, rubber, cork, and anodized aluminum. The Reno 65W Pro has a large 16 inch by 20 inch work area and a Z height of 100 millimeters or 3.94 inches. It has a maximum speed of 800 millimeters per second, which will quickly engrave or cut your projects. It also has an optional rotary attachment to allow you to engrave cylindrical objects such as tumblers. Another key feature of the Pro version is that it is light burn compatible, which I think is critical. I think the Reno 65W Pro is a very valuable tool that most people could benefit from having it in their workshop or small business. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Bye.